Hello, hopefully finally welcome to John Wren Stadium. As we're hoping finally we get this stream up and working. I'll tell you what, if you're able to hear me right now, first off, thank God. Second off, every single thing that has gone wrong, every single thing that will go wrong has gone wrong as Purdy trying to find Dickey to close out the first half. Thirty-two point six seconds left to go right now. Perry in scoring territory, at least a field goal. This has been a lot closer game. 14-14 is our score right now as we're headed into the end of the first half. And right now, at least at the beginning of the game, Brian, Valley Vista had their way with Perry.
Yeah, well, you know, the big players we talked about earlier making the big plays, so getting good production out of their wide receiver position and their quarterback. And you know, Pumas kind of came in flat and have responded pretty nice to the initial punch in the mouth by the Monsoon. So see if the Pumas can score here late with 32 seconds left and go up in halftime with a lead and then get the ball to start the second half.
As Brian said, the key guys, and we'll kind of key on this more at the break. We're talking about guys like number 5, Ray Baquero, who's gotten some carries here tonight. Number 20, the big one, is Vadre Gates. Gates, the best probably athlete on the Valley Vista team. Already is caught for a touchdown, I think. Baquero's already scored. Perry has run a trick play, and they got into the end zone. There it is, number 93, Tate Speaker in the end zone for his second touchdown of the game. And just like that, the Perrys reclaim the lead, up by 6, pending the PAT.
So Pumas respond at the end of the half. We were talking about maybe not getting up because there's only a minute, but good score. And just like we like to see, score at the end of the half, get the ball, go down and score, big swings in games.
That's right. Could be a 14-point swing in Perry's favor. There you see right there, number 5, Colby Dickey to hold Zendejas. That's a good shot right there as well. Zendejas, good snap, good hold, good kick. And Perry go up by 7, 21-14. High scoring affair in the first half. Valley Vista with only 27 seconds left. We're about half a yard away from giving up a safety earlier in this game. Perry done well to fight and grab the lead, which sounds a little bit weird when you're talking about a team from Surprise. But I was saying earlier when we were trying to get this thing going, trying to get the stream going, Valley Vista, I feel like kind of the Boise State syndrome, to where they have a good record. They're coming into this game at 7-3, but just haven't been tested as much as Perry has, obviously.
No, we talked about a couple of games against East Valley teams didn't go so well for them. Anytime they played the big boys out in the West, like Westview, ran in a little bit of trouble. Did not play Centennial this year, who's also the big dog on the West side. And so when they faced those big teams, they had trouble getting into the thing.
So back deep to return for Valley Vista with about 30 seconds left, a little bit under 30 seconds, is number 20, Vadre Gates. As Zendejas pushes this one to the 30-yard line, and that's where the receiver is going to be hit hard, and it's going to be where he stopped with 25 ticks on the clock. Very back and forth game. We saw Perry take a 14-7 lead, and in the box while we were trying to wait for the internet, thought possibly could that be it for Valley Vista. They go up by 7, had a chance to go up 10 on 4th and goal from Perry's 9-yard line. They decided to go for it and came up short, decided not to take the 3 points. And I thought especially that was going to bite them, but they bounced back. They tied the game at 14, couple stalled drives later, and Perry would go on to get the score as we just brought to you. So now with 25 seconds, let's see what they draw up here from their own 30-yard line. And it's Reyes Laura. Vadre Gates in motion. Laura in the gun, gets a snap, is going to turn right on the flat to Gates. Gates with some room to run, bounces outside. Let's see, did he get out of bounds? Looks like he got pushed out. It's going to be a gain of about 7 there for Vadre Gates. Gates been tearing the Pumas up all night. And you know Coach Jones and this Perry team, very, very key, very, very good as well at making halftime adjustments. And you have to think that Vadre Gates keying up on him would be the big halftime adjustment.
Yeah, that's the thing about Vadre Gates. It's easy to say you're going to want to stop him, but it's another thing when it's going live and the speed of the game's going. And he's shifting, he's a little guy, and you don't see those guys a lot. And it's really hard when it's you're facing it one-on-one and kind of have to adjust and chase that down. He's a shifty, quick player.
We'll talk about shifty and quick. Laura's throwing deep for Collier. Did he catch that? No, he did not. He's saying he's out of bounds, and Collier cannot believe it. That looked like a catch from here. Let's take a look on the replay. And here we go. Let's see.
Yeah, just a go route down below, fake to Vadre Davis. It looks like a catch from up here. That's a catch.
Oh, that's a catch. He got both feet in.
Yeah, both feet.
He had both feet in.
No replay for them, but, hey, Pumas dodge a bullet at the end of the half with the chance to kind of get a throw up there into the end zone for a Hail Mary, but great catch. You know, he had trouble catching the ball earlier. Collier dropped someone wide open, and he makes that circus catch off the top of the shoulder pad.
Wow.
A la David Tyree sticking it to the shoulder pad. Here we go.
Oh, is that going to be ruled a fumble? No, they're saying it's incomplete. Perry were playing their kind of their cloud defense, just the home run, the Hail Mary prevent, whatever you want to call it. That's the type of defense they had. One, two, three, four guys. And now it looks like Valley Vista, with 8 seconds, are going to punt this away.
Awesome. We're looking at halftime.
So Kobe Dickey will be back deep to return. Good odds. He waves his hand for the fair catch. Not the best of punts, as we've seen from Valley Vista. Dickey, lets this one bounce. Now he's going to pick it up. Nobody. They all fell asleep. Kobe Dickey fell asleep. Wow, what a play. Heads up play by Kobe Dickey. Everybody fell asleep on the play, maybe including a couple of us up here. Kobe Dickey waving his hands, saying, no, no, no. Let's take a look here on the replay. Low snap, high kick. That's going to be the end of the half. That's probably why Dickey decided to pick it up. As you see here, the ball takes a bounce. Everyone's just standing around it. And Dickey right from behind. Whoop! See you later. Trying to make something out of nothing. But that does bring our first half to a close. Dickey, like I said, trying to make a circus play out of nothing. So
did you go Chris Berman right there? With
that was a little bit of a whoop.
Wow.
Yeah, you got to pay homage to the great play-by-players for his one game a night he does on Monday night.
Nice.
Or one game a year, I should say. It wasn't a lot. We were able to bring you in the first half. But that is the end of our first half. 21-14 our score. Perry on top of Valley Vista. I was about to say Desert Vista. 21-14. Pumas over the Monsoon. Should be an exciting second half, and we will bring that to you live. First, we have a pre-recorded tape between Bernier and I about this Valley Vista team to bring some knowledge, because even the players were a little bit ignorant to what Valley Vista was all about. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Playoff Football. That's right, Playoff Football here on PS4. I'm Jordan Palacio alongside Brian Bernier, as always. Perry going up against Valley Vista, the 9-1 Perry team, going up against a team we don't really know a lot about, Brian.
No Westside team. We don't see the Westside teams a lot out here.
No.
Only team that they played out from the East Valley is Skyline, and they lost 24-21, and they also lost to Mountain View and gave up 42 points. So, you know, the Westside teams play kind of the West Side teams, and they don't have a lot of success in playoff games coming out this way, and so we'll see if Valley Vista can change that.
Now, for Valley Vista, the Monsoon, as they're known as, who are some of the guys that we might need to look out for?
Looking up on the stats, you got the quarterback is obviously their leader, Reyes Lora, who has thrown for 2,000 yards on the season, 25 touchdowns, just 5 interceptions, so obviously getting good production out of him, only 5'10", so on the smaller side for a quarterback. And so also their running back has really made hay this year, and that is Ray Vaquero. And Vaquero, 1,100 yards on the year, 14 touchdowns. So they got some offensive firepower they've shown throughout the season. But I want to look for this guy, Vadre Gates. What a name.
What a name.
Up
what
on the
a
marquee,
name. That's right.
800 yards receiving on the season, 10 touchdowns, obviously their go-to guy through the air.
And now for Perry, we've been covering a lot about Brock Purdy, but it's not just been Purdy this year for the Pumas.
A couple new guys coming up through the ranks at running back, Clayson Conrad and Colby Dickey, right?
Yeah, Clayson Conrad's a really tough load to bring down. We've seen him in the last 3 weeks kind of emerge as the number one tailback.
Right.
And some big runs against Hamilton, we saw that Pyle would kind of sit there and he'd pop out and take off running. So getting a lot of good production out of him in the backfield. And Colby Dickey, out of nowhere.
Out of nowhere, right.
Big plays. Definitely. I mean, just, you know, a couple really long touchdown catches. And he's approaching the 1,000-yard range on the season as well. So it's not all Nate James and Brock Purdy. We have other people contributing big on the offensive side of the ball.
Definitely helps to have more than one threat at wide receiver. That's right. Playoff football coming up next. But first, some highlights from the previous weeks of this season. Like I said, Valley Vista against Perry live on PS4. Kickoff coming soon.
Throws over the middle, wide open, touchdown Perry. What a response for the Pumas, number 99 on the catch. Games in the slot. Purdy's gonna throw for the end zone. He's got a man, it's caught, touchdown. Welcome back to John Wren Stadium. Getting revved and ready to go for second half action. 21-14 our score. Perry on top of Valley Vista in a surprisingly closely contested game. A lot of people were thinking that this was going to be a game that was going to be over in a quarter. However, not the case this week. However, before we get going at the kickoff, just over a minute left to go before kickoff. Real quick, since technical difficulties prevented us from bringing you the first half, I'd like to, if I could, humor you guys and bring the recap of the first half. So Valley Vista started off with the ball, drove down the field with ease on the Pumas, and scored in about a minute or two. Very, very good drive. Went down 80 yards after a touchback, 7-0 Valley Vista. Valley Vista then got a stop on defense, got off the field on a fourth down, forced a turnover on downs. They drove down the field again, got to the 9-yard line, and on fourth and goal from the 9-yard line, decided to go for it, and that's still a decision that kind of is, I really don't like that. They go for it on fourth and 9, do not get it, and Perry get the big stop. Then Perry go down the field, and they get their first score of the game. We're all knotted up at 7-7 a little bit later on in the game after a couple of stalled Valley Vista drives. Perry went on to score and make that 14-7 their favor. And then as the second quarter came, Valley Vista tied things up on a big pass to Vaudre Gates from Reyes Laura, 14-14. And then we saw it at the end of the first half, Brock Purdy to Tate Speaker in the end zone. It's a play they've been running all year long. And that's where we stand right now, 21-14, and Perry having a chance to capitalize on the 14-point swing that comes with scoring at the end of the half, headed into the second half. On the kick right now for Valley Vista is number 99 of all numbers. And there, right now what you're hearing is our on-field audio that we're able to get working as well. The kick just a little pooch as Perry trying to make something out of nothing. The kicker for Valley Vista, senior Jared Lang, 5'10 senior, 160, not a small kicker. So at the 45, Valley Vista decided not to mess with Nate James, and I believe David Eppinger was also back there. Pretty wise decision, but that means Perry gets the ball at the 45. Good field position for the Pumas.
Yeah, just what they needed here coming into the second half.
And Brock on his first play throws left side, caught. Then depending on the spot, it's either going to be a yard short or first down. Let's see where they give him.
Pumas all just kind of out of sync early. And so now trying to get back to the regular offense and see if they can keep this thing going here. Their speed that they usually have.
First down, Pumas. They're going to give to Kenny Fultz. Fultz on the left side got some room to run to the 40, and that's where he's going to be taken down at about the 39 or 38. So good little run there, keeping the Pumas on schedule.
Yeah, that's what we talked about, too, with Fultz. We hadn't seen him
right at
running back for a long time.
Yep.
So talking to the coaches up here, Fultz was playing exclusively DB for a long time. And talked to coaches up here, we got Darius Holton back at corner. He was injured, and that made the move for Fultz back to running back.
Four wide for the Pumas. Purdy's going to keep himself on a design run. And there he goes. Brock Purdy to the right hash. Now he's got room to run to 15. 10, 5's got 1 minute to beat. He's in. Touchdown, Brock Purdy. 39-yard run. He's been doing that all year long, and he does it again. There it is, the 14-point swing. Perry on top, 27-14.
Yeah, great run by Purdy. You see him take off here, fakes the run, outruns defenders, makes a nice cut. Good field vision here for Purdy. Gets down, gets a block. Dives in the end zone, touchdown, Brock Purdy, killing him with his legs on a big run.
Hits the Jets, and see you later. Brock Purdy does it again with his feet, giving the Pumas another score. Now Zendejas on for the point after.
Yeah, wait for that big play all night from Purdy. We get it right there, start the second half.
28-14 now our score, 11:03. That drive only taking 57 seconds. That's all you need when you got Brock Purdy over there catching your snap, slinging the rock, or running the ball into the end zone from about 40 out.
Yeah, that's kind of what we expected a little bit more of this game when we were getting our prep work done for the week, and so hadn't seen that yet, and that's the big play we needed.
So now for Valley Vista, could be coming into where if they don't get a score on this drive or in the next couple of drives, things could be getting pretty ugly. You know, that's kind of what we were thinking earlier when Perry went up by a score at 14-7. We were thinking that Valley Vista, ooh, will they respond? They did end up responding. It's going to be interesting to see if they can here. Again, the big guy to watch on the Valley Vista offense is number 20, Vaudre Gates. Gates has been tearing the Pumas a new one all night. Let's see what they do here. Zendejas pushes his sky-high kick. Almost dropped. But Valley Vista hold on. Number 12 there for the monsoon. Brandon Hu.
How does it sound, man? keeps pausing. You sound good? Okay, make sure both of us sound good. I don't care what it sounds like in there. You need to hear what it sounds like on the screen.
Yeah, that's
what. So, yeah, we've talked about how Laura and this Valley Vista offense has been game to try to keep pace and been doing a great job. See if the Pumas' adjustments at halftime shut this down.
Laura's going to keep it throw on the flat to Gates. Gates caught that on a knee, and there it is. Now he's called down.
Yeah, and that play, you know, you're trying to get him the ball in space, and it's a nice, easy pitch and catch. But when he's catching it 5 yards deep, you're expecting a lot of movement out of that runner with the ball. And so I'm not sure the Pumas are a team that is to do that against, because really they run to the ball so well, that's something you'd have to be aware of, them tackling for a loss.
Now the thing with this Valley Vista offense is they're not going to want to shoot out against the Pumas.
Most likely not.
As Baquero gets up, it's going to be third and still a country mile. So that being said, they're going to have to find a couple of stops on defense somehow and then go from there and turn that into points. And especially when you're looking at third and 14, it doesn't look likely. But, I mean, obviously we saw it at the end of the first half, they converted on a third and 14. And especially when you have a guy like Vadre Gates, who we've seen make plays in the film before the game and even in this game, you got a chance.
Yeah, that's who you looked for them to go to here, and they're going to look right at him right now. There he is.
There is Vadre Gates. He's got a break a tackle, and there he goes. Vadre Gates at the marker gets pushed forward. First down, I just said it. Third and 14. Gates is the go-to man.
So you see nice, easy little drive pass here. Drags across the field. Laura finds time, makes the play, and we miss the shot.
Laura flushed out of the pocket on that play, found Gates. Now they're going to give off to Baquero. Baquero had a good first drive, but after that, nothing doing there.
Yeah, now Baquero not getting the space that he had earlier in this game. Puma's taking that away real quick. You can see that adjustment already. He had some pretty big holes early, and those are closing up very fast for the 665-pound running back.
Well, and for this Perry defense, that's what we've seen out of them all year, with the exception of that Chandler game where T.J. Green went off. But that's what we've seen. They've been able to stop the run. We saw it especially against Hamilton, against Gerard Jordan, and it's been no exception here tonight.
Yeah, I mean, they do a good job of staying gaps down and controlling those gaps. And so, you know, Valley Vista big up front, but not really able to move this offensive, our defensive line's really quick.
Out of the pistol, Laura gets a snap. He's going to step up. He's going to look to run, and there he goes, falling over his own feet. He was down.
So you can see Laura takes off here and gets going out of the pocket on this play. And he kind of reminds me of Jeremiah Mazzoli, an old Oregon running back. And I don't know, you know, if the ball hits first, that's a fumble. Okay.
So,
third and 10. Third and 10 right now for Valley Vista. Big third down. They converted to third and 14 earlier in the drive. It's Laura. Reyes Laura in the pistol. Baquero in behind. Little three-step drop. He's going to have to throw and does to Vadre Gates. Vadre cups upfield, stays on his feet, gets past two Puma defenders, out of bounds at the 30-yard line. Vadre Gates, we're going to be saying his name all night long. First down, Monsoon.
So you can see again, they're just trying to get Gates in space any which way they can. Drag across from the other side of the field. No defender there. Makes a little move, nice move, and then takes a big hit as he goes out of bounds.
That's been the whole game plan right now for Valley Vista, is just get him the ball.
Can you get the scoreboard off of the replay? Is that too much? Just because it's harder to tell.
Right there, that's a great shot of Vadre Gates. Vadre tearing the Pumas up. Now they're going to look to throw. End zone. Underthrown, possibly almost intercepted. Number one, Gavin Smith right there for Valley Vista. Did a good job playing defense on offense.
Yeah, we talked about that in the first half, too. We talked about that in the first half as far as the fact that they're going at Effinger, who's the last guy you want to throw against. And he's got a height advantage up top, Valley Vista does, but Effinger's got good position. You saw him get big picks against bigger receivers against Hamilton. And it's not really a ball I want to play. That kid is not definitely not Chance from
Chase
Hamilton.
Brewington from Hamilton, yeah. Yes. Now second and 10. Maybe the only time these guys can convert is on third down. They're going to give to Baquero. Baquero, nothing doing there. Met by two Puma defenders at the line of scrimmage, third and 10.
Yeah, you know, they've used Gates as bait a couple times going across the field there, and they haven't given the ball yet. So you got to think that's coming at some point because the bait has not been taken by this Puma defense.
Yeah, Pumas, as you said, very gap sound, staying at home on those types of plays. Third and 10 from the 29-yard line on the Perry side of the field. Laura in the pistol, Baquero in behind, four wide set. He's going to look to throw left side, looking for Collier. Collier in the end zone, incomplete. Good defense there, keeping Valley Vista off the board.
Yeah, good job by the Pumas taking that away down the sideline. We missed a shot. We got a shot of a pole for you there, but we got an awning up top there that those side shots down on each end are going to run a little bit of the awning. Maybe we can move that camera up a little bit.
Darius Holton on the coverage for the Pumas. So here we go. Now fourth and 10. Offense stays on the field. You really have to. If they didn't feel comfortable kicking a field goal from the 9-yard line, you doubt they would from the 29-yard line. Fourth and 10. Vodger Gates is the guy to watch. They got him to jump off sides. Wow, that one hurts.
Going to get half of it back. Yeah, this Puma defense is usually a lot more disciplined than that. That's a surprise to see, especially knowing that's kind of a likely play to come here.
Look like number 7 for the Pumas, Devin Cowan, jumped off. It's now 4th and 5 from the 24-yard line. Four wide set, two on each side for Valley Vista. Reyes Lora, the quarterback, again in the pistol. Gets the snap, little step drop, throws in the middle to Gates. Gates joggles, spins out of a tackle. Vodre Gates, can you believe it? How many times are we going to say his name? Juggles the ball in the air, spins out of a tackle. I'm not even sure he saw. And then gets in the end zone. Touchdown, Valley Vista.
Yeah, Gates doing his thing. Getting loose, moving around. Just another little drag route. Makes the spin move,
wow.
Breaks the tackle. Great job by Gates.
So on for the point after. A little bit, it looked like a toe poke right there from the Valley Vista kicker, number 84. There you see Vodre Gates.
Nice little Mark Mosley toe gate. That's like Redskins 1980s right there.
Yeah.
Obviously going to have to do something with Gates. No ability to stop him so far in this game.
It's not even been complicated, really, what they're doing. But you said it. It's one thing to plan for him. It's another thing to stop him.
Yeah.
It's just been little quick hitter routes and let Gates go, and he's been able to get the upper hand on this Puma defense.
Yeah, it's one of those ones where, you know, they run that drag. At some point, you're going to have that backer look him up and take him out when he comes across there and not let him cross your face. And he's crossing people's faces left and right, and it's a pretty easy pitch and catch for the quarterback and him. So Laura doing a great job of getting him the ball.
Very, very interesting to see, too. I don't know, are you getting a little bit of the feel of the Nate James vibe out of Vodre Gates? That's what I'm seeing. Just get him the ball and watch him create as a little squibber takes the Pumas to the 40-yard line. That's what I'm kind of getting out of Vodre is get him the ball and he creates.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely the same type of player. We haven't tested his hands on anything on the outside. Everything's been a drag or something.
Yep.
Across the middle and then little swings, and he's killed us on that drag route all night.
So now the Pumas retake the field, headed by Brock Purdy, junior quarterback.
It's janky here, I know that.
They're going to get to Nate James on the jet sweep, and there goes Nate James. You're just talking about it, but this play is going to be coming back. Flag thrown by the referee from Malkovich in the area of holding. As again, that's from the spot of the foul, so it's going to be... Yeah, but that's the call right there. It's going to be holding on the Pumas. And Nate James, now what you want to see, coming up, shaking up. Gingerly walking back to the huddle. Let's see if we can see the hold. He just tackles him. I don't know if that was a hold. That just looked like a good block. But nonetheless, hold was the call. 6:45 left to go in the third quarter. Purdy's going to keep himself, look to go deep. It's almost intercepted by Valley Vista. Number 8, Yvon Hinson on the coverage. You see him wagging his finger right there, giving him a little bit of a Dikembe Mutombo. Second and 19 after the hold and the incompletion. Four wide set for the Pumas. They're going to put Kenny Foltz in motion. Don't give the ball to him. Purdy steps up in the pocket. Finds Nate James, and he can't hang on. A rare Nate James drop. And now you got third and very long. And you have to question, maybe because he was walking gingerly on the play before. Maybe he's still a little bit shaken up. I don't know. But now on third and 19, you know, this is something we've seen, a screen for James. We've seen Nate James kind of, they let the receivers get out in front. Now Pumas are going to make a sub. They're going to bring on Kenny Foltz in favor. Now we got a timeout and the Pumas are going to burn one. So Pumas timeout, up by 7, 3rd and 19, however. Right now, my color guy, Brian, doing his best to troubleshoot as per usual. I mentioned earlier that everything that has gone wrong, or that will go wrong, has gone wrong for us. No exception here. Looks like our scoreboard has gone down. Live Text, the program that we use to use our scoreboard, has just stopped working on us. However, show must go on, right? Now, in the show right now, 3rd and 19, Brock Purdy in the gun. 3 wide sets. Pete Moore in motion for the Pumas. Purdy's looking to throw. He's going to throw deep. Looking for the big man, DeShane. DeShane brings it down. Stays on his feet. DeShane James on a huge reception. First down, Perry, on Valley Vista's side of the field.
Yeah, DeShane James just gets inside leverage. Purdy throws it up, and the big man pulls it down for the huge gain on third down for the Pumas.
That play might seem bigger than it seems. If they don't get that, Valley Vista gets the ball back, riding the momentum on their side, having a chance to tie, but now it's first and 10 from Valley Vista's 34. Pumas still trying to go up by 2 scores now as Purdy's going to look to throw. Finds Nate James. Nate James can't get by the first one. Is going to gain about 3 or 4 there on the catch. .535, I'll do my best to keep everyone updated on the score and the time. Purdy gonna throw deep for DeShane, he's got him! Touchdown, Perry! Brock Purdy to DeShane James from 32 yards out, and that's what I was saying, that third down conversion might seem bigger than it seemed. Touchdown, Perry!
Yeah, again, get the big man in space out there on a post route, just bodies him up, takes it away, like a Dennis Rodman going up for a rebound. Uses the body, can't go through him. Touchdown, Pumas. Nice throw and catch.
Perry keeping up the pace offensively. Another touchdown. Zendejas on for the point after. It's straight down the middle. Zendejas very good at the point after game. 35-21, our score with 5:28 left to go in the third quarter. Pumas up by 14 yet again. On the kick now for the Pumas is Christian Zendejas back deep to return. Looks like we got a couple new guys back there to return for Valley Vista. Number 12, Brandon Hu. And it looks like number 8, Ivan Hinson, as Zendejas just boosts this. And it's going to roll out of bounds after being touched by number 21, Darren Perkins of Valley Vista. Now excuse the following plug, but you want to show your school and your team just how much spirit and passion you have. Follow AZ Preps 365 on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. Right there, you can post your picks and share your thoughts using hashtag AZPreps365. And the hashtag for this game has been a little bit of a surprising emoji, if you can do that. That was doing my best to relate the ad. And back with the game is right now we got Laura. Laura's going to run. Last time he tried to do this, he slipped on his own feet. But this time he's going to cut up the field, take a huge shot from Devin Cowan. First down, Valley Vista, but Laura paying the price for it. And you see here on the replay him pump faking our own camera guy getting faked out by the pump fake. Wow. Noah Perucci on the camera work right there. I'm not afraid to name drop him right there. Getting his ankles broken and then some by the pump fake. Laura's going to tuck it in and run, and there it is. There he slept on his own feet again. And he's going to drop a yard on the carry. Second and 11 now for the Monsoon. Second and 11, down by 14, 4:45 to go in the third. It's very interesting, Brian. I might get in trouble for saying this, but we don't have our scoreboard right now, but if you want to see a different version of our scoreboard, you can log on very quickly to the Chandler stream. They have something that looks very similar. As Reyes Laura trying to find Baquero on the flats, incomplete. Now third and long. And if you were going to be waving any red flags as a warning sign for this one getting out of hand, this would be this play right here. Third and 11, down by 14, in danger of getting out of hand for sure for the Monsoon. Third and 11, 4:21 left to go. Laura drops back, throws right side, looking for Vajre Gates. That falls incomplete. A little bit of a baffling decision there to throw to Vajre. Vajre coming off of a comeback route, running toward the line of scrimmage. So even if he caught that with the defender right on him, would have been short of the first down. And now Valley Vista forced to punt. As there you see the returner for Perry, Colby Dickey. Dickey has been such a threat offensively for these Pumas. We talked about him at the half. Usually his job for returning these punts has just been make sure you catch it and wave your hand for the fair catch. Oh, weird snap there. They had to adjust, and the punt goes out of bounds at the Perry 45. That is a 7-yard punt. Not even at the 45, at the 40. In a non-wind condition, no wind blowing around right now at John Wren Stadium. A 2-yard punt that's netted as.
That's what we
call that one's going to hurt the stats.
The old shanks for coming punt.
Yeah. that one hurts. If that was any sign that the wheels might be falling off for Valley Vista, that might have been it. Brock Purdy and this Puma offense retake the field now. And they're going to give to Fultz. Kenny Fultz. Good run there from Fultz. Gets about 6 or 7 on the carry. Second and short. There you see Fultz. Fultz, a little bit of a question mark all season long, if I could pronounce that word correctly. He's been playing defense, then playing offense, then back to defense. Really a position I don't think he's played yet, maybe except for kickers. They give to Dickey on the jet sweep. Let's see where they spot him. He was close to the marker on second and short, and he's going to be short, it looks like. Third and inches to third and one here for the Pumas. Very manageable, though.
Yeah, the kill shot may be coming here for the Pumas late in this third quarter. Pumas in range right now to put tremendous pressure on Valley Vista.
Three minutes and counting left to go in the third of four frames here as the Puma offense looks to the sideline to get the signals from Coach Jones. Purdy's going to give to the backup running back this game, Clayson Conrad. Conrad breaks the tackle up to the 20, to the 15, and that's where he's tackled. First down, Puma is inside the red zone. As we see on the replay here, Conrad bouncing it outside, being able to get through all those bodies and just keep the feet moving until his feet were wrapped up. And on this play, who's open in the end zone? Guess who? Number 10, Nate James, for 14 yards out. Purdy to James, just that easy. And this has turned into an easy half for the Pumas. Three straight scores, 41-21, Pumas on top. Zendejas on for the point after. It looks like the Pumas are missing a body to come help. And they're going to send out Brock Purdy to hold the snap. Purdy does the job well. Good hold, and the kick is up and through the uprights. 42-21. And this is the game we thought we were going to see out of these guys. 21-point lead for the Pumas as things wind down in the third quarter. 2:35 left to go. Now, if I can break out the reading glasses for a second, the Arizona Intergalactic Association would like to recognize the following partners of the AIA State High School Tournaments, one of these being the U.S. Army. As it says, in life, some things you can't control, such as no internet in the press box, for example. But there are things, there are those things that you can, important things like your future. The Army is all about the freedom to create a strong future that's right for your life. To learn more, visit goarmy.com/AIA today. They're strong, and then there's Army strong. And speaking of strong, it's been all about the Pumas offensively being strong, overpowering the Valley Vista defense as they've had the second half. As Zendejas boots this one away, and I say boots kind of facetiously, as it looks like Vaudre Gates, was that Vaudre Gates trying to hurdle over a couple of prone bodies? Let's take a look here on the replay. No spotters in the box, so we're kind of just free-eyeing this, if you will. As you see here, picks the ball up about the 20. Yeah, and then trying to hurdle over a couple of guys on the ground. Reyes Lora in the pistol, where he's been most of the night. He's going to give to Baquero. Baquero able to create something there, a good run, something we haven't been able to see much of for this Vista offense. It's going to be about second and six. Man in motion to snap. The center could not get the snap. It looks like he hit himself on the snap, causing Lohr just to fall on it. So now we got third and close to the original line of scrimmage. It looks like third and nine here for Valley Vista. As let's take a look on the replay here. Yeah, look, see, I wonder what they were trying to do. Man in motion, just the center. Looks like he just hit himself with the snap. Now with about 90 seconds left to go in the third quarter, Valley Vista down 21. Might need a small miracle to come back in this game. Lohr steps up in the pocket, finds Collier. Collier's going to be a yard short of the markers. And let's see what Valley Vista choose to do here. Down by 20 points. Coming to the end of the third quarter, I wouldn't be surprised if they go for it here. I think you have to if you want any type of actual chance in this game. You have to go for it, especially with the way Perry's been playing offensively. Four wide set for the Monsoon. Lohr again in the pistol. I feel like that might be like maybe their favorite formation. Lohr's going to have to roll on fourth and one. Thought about throwing it, tucks it in. Where are they going to be spotting him? He's going to be spotted short. Wow, Lohr running out of bounds. Looks like a yard short. Yes, it is going to be a yard short. Perry football. Lohr can't get across the markers. Let's see where he goes. He gets flushed out of the pocket, as you can see, having to scramble. It looked like number 42, Neil Callen, might have been right there to try and force him even further outside. And essentially, Lohr just ran out of real estate. First down, Perry on Valley Vista's 43-yard line. And again, if I could, before Perry's offense take the team, before Perry's offense take the field, actually, just kidding, we'll save that for later after Perry probably go down the field and score on this drive. That might have just been commentator's curse. If Perry turned the ball over, that was because of me. I'll take full responsibility for that. I feel like that's going to come back to get me. 40.5 seconds left to go in the third. Perry up by 21. Purdy keeps himself. Going to look to roll, being flushed out of the pocket. I think no matter what this play is, it's coming back. Purdy going to run. Huge block there. Another flag. That's going to be a targeting. We got two flags on Perry. This is going to be first and a country mile. Let's take a look at the replay here. Purdy in the gun. Being flushed out of the pocket. You got a hold right there. You see the flag flying in. And a huge hit. Watch out. Bang. That one's going to hurt in the morning. There was another flag. The white hat official threw his hat. Going to be two flags on Perry. And the referee's talking it over right now. That one hurt. Let's take a look at the signal from the ref. We got a block in the back, or a hold, excuse me. That's declined. And then a personal foul. A crackback block. That was the official call from John Prothro, the PA, voice of the Perry Pumas here at John Wren Stadium. So the personal foul is going to make things first and a very, very long way to go. And there you see Purdy's going to roll left. He's going to have the long way to go here to get the first down. Stays on his feet. He'll be second and still very long. It was first and 33 regardless, and that's probably going to be the end of the third quarter. So at the end of three, Perry go for three scores, 42-21. Our score going into the fourth quarter. This is more like the game we thought we were going to see. So like I said, if I could be afforded to break out the reading glasses. One of the AIA's partners in these state tournaments is Arizona Christian University. And if you did not know, I'll inform you right now whether you wanted to know or not. ACU is a private, nonprofit Christian university in Phoenix offering bachelor's degrees in a variety of different areas of study. ACU provides a biblically integrated education that prepares its graduates to serve the Lord in ministries and professional occupations. Visit arizonachristian.edu for more information. Now, you might be surprised here as these ads we're reading out. The spelling is not superb. We're kind of doing some spell check on the fly with these things.
Yeah, we'll make them bigger next time. Script's a little small.
Maybe.
Maybe one for each deal here. So there's no scoreboard. The computer decided not to work.
As I said, everything that will go wrong has gone wrong for us pretty much tonight.
We're using boot camp on the computer for a Mac to run the scoreboard. And it won't charge when it's in boot camp.
First play of the first fourth quarter. Purdy finds Pete Mora for first down, bringing things onto Vista's side of the field. As they see the whiteout tonight, Perry student section in more of a higher force than I thought they were going to be in. You know, you're coming against a team, a lowly team like Valley Vista. Not a lot of recognition given to them. Not a lot of people know who they were, even on the football team.
But the $5 cover charge might affect that as well.
As
AIA
well, that's what I was.
Requires the
that's what I was
going to
say.
Charge.
Four wide for Purdy. He's going to roll to the left side. He's got room. Throws left side. Looking for Nate James. Looks like he kind of forced that one. Maybe put in a spot where he thought Nate could only get it himself. Incomplete third down for Perry. Fourth down now, actually.
I think if you see these two this team next week at home against Hamilton, we won't have to worry about that student section being a little thin.
Right.
I think it'll be packed to the gills on both sides.
And AIA will be loving every single second of it.
Yeah. A matchup they would want with two teams from the region. We talk about this bracket and how this bracket's set up. Really a disadvantage for the Premier Region. You have four teams from the Premier Region all on one side of the bracket.
Right.
And so they're going to eliminate a Chandler school come hell or high water the way that bracket was set up with the formulaic mystery called the PowerPoint system the AIA uses.
Purdy thought about going deep, decided to tuck it in and run. Wisely does, and he gets the first down at around the 30-yard line. About a 13-yard carry on fourth down, no less, to get the first down and keep the drive alive.
Yeah, that math may be similar to Donald Trump's economic plan, voodoo economics, any of those other things you've seen pop up around a long time. So let's see if the Pumas can get this out.
Purdy's going to have to break a couple pairs of ankles and does. Now tucks it in and run. Got some room on the left side to the 25, to the 20. Brock Purdy tiptoeing his way out of bounds to the 20-yard line. That's a little bit of a harsh spot, I think. Let's take a look on the replay if you can see. As you see Purdy having to improvise right here, tucks it in, gets to the 30, gets to the 25, then having to tiptoe. Maybe that right foot was a little bit close. I don't know. First down, nonetheless, at the 19 with Clayson Conrad in behind at the pistol, and Valley Vista, well, they're claiming that Perry moved, and that's going to be the call. It's going to be a false start on Perry. So that's going to back them up five.
Pretty even as far as penalties have gone in this game. No, not too many flags. Not NFL-style flag every other play that we've seen so far in the NFL.
Well,
so
I was going to say, even with this Perry team, we've gone up there in game time length, couple to 2 to 3 hour games. Compared to those games, this one's been quick, relatively. As Purdy on the design run, the QB draw, picks up about good yardage in terms of the down and distance. It's still going to be third and long, about third and seven, it looks like.
Yeah, I'd like to see the Pumas be able to get Purdy out of the game here. So get a score, get him out, get the starters rested for this last 10 minutes of this game. 42-21 right now. You got to figure they go up 49-21. It's time to bring in the backup.
That's an interesting point because we were saying that against Hamilton. As Purdy's going to have to step up and run, and he gets hit and takes out another alignment as well. We were saying against Hamilton, that's a good segue into the point that I'm about to make. They were killing Hamilton. They're up by 20 to 30 in the later parts of that game, and they left Purdy in the entire way.
I think that was a
statement.
Yes. Without a doubt, that was a, hey, we got you. We're going to take advantage of every single moment of this game. And so, you know, you got to get those younger guys raised up and ready to go. And, you know, and Raising Cane's is looking for the best Arizona high school football fans in the state. Stop by your nearest Raising Cane's location. Take a picture of you and your friends in your high school football gear and send that picture to hashtag FingersFridayFootball. The best picture of the month will receive free Raising Cane's
for
a
year.
Remember, stop by Raising Cane's on game day, take a picture, and send it to hashtag FingersFridayFootball for a chance to win. Raising Cane's, official chicken finger of the AIA.
Now the official chicken finger of the AIA.
Just open one up down the street from us on Val Vista and...
Don't ask, but I don't live on that side of town.
On Chandler? Val Vista and Chandler, right? Val Vista and Williamsfield. Just open a Raising Cane's up there on that corner. Just opened about 2-3 weeks ago. And I went there at lunch the other day,
packed
with high school kids.
Well, I'll tell you what, Raising Cane's gets a lot of praise from some of the guys here at the crew.
A lot of credit, TrueRest Credit Union is proud of sponsor of the AIA. Arizona high school students can get a jump start on financial success with TrueWest's My Money program for teens. Learn more at truewest.org/mymoney.
Can Clayson Conrad be money? Yes, he is. Clayson Conrad is money. Into the end zone. Touchdown, Pumas, from 5 yards out. Now this game is over. Perry killing Valley Vista as we thought they would. And there is the senior, Clayson Conrad, in his next-to-last game at home of the year.
Yeah, Conrad, we talked about, previewed in the game time before, and player that had been doing well and kind of was pushed aside tonight for the first half, but comes in the second half and gets his touchdown to put this game out of reach for Valley Vista.
Zendejas' point after is up and through. Good segue right there with the money and the credit. It's almost like we planned that one.
Obviously, it was planned. Like everything else tonight.
Very, very true.
So 49-21, and something we thought would happen in this game and
yep.
Kind of get up. And so still 9:48 left. You got to see, should see the benches clear for the Pumas here and see this Valley Vista team try to fight it out their last 9 minutes of some of their careers here for high school football. So lots of other action for Perry in the playoffs going on. All fall sports qualified for state championships.
Yep.
Perry last year, one of the few schools in the state that had qualified in every single sport for state. So every team here doing well.
Badminton went to the state championship, coming up short against Xavier. But Xavier, I heard this stat, and maybe you know a little bit better than I do, knowing you are the more badminton expertise one of us here in the group. I was heard that Xavier hasn't lost a game in something like, or a game to Perry at least, in something like 4 years or something like that, Brian.
Yeah, I mean, Xavier, it's anything that has to do with the country club, Xavier's pretty good at. And so swimming and golf and all those things are very, very much a part of their success in sports. And so I guess badminton's a country club sport as well. I guess if there's a racket and something to hit, just like tennis.
Right.
So Pumas have not been able to get over the hump, but hey, two trips to the state championship in the last 2 years, the most successful program on campus.
Oh, without a doubt.
Being consistent.
Without a doubt.
So Coach Johnson doing a great job. And has a lot of kids coming back for next year as well. So look for him to be right there again next year.
And then if I'm not mistaken, right, volleyball right now doing very well in their playoffs. Played a game on Wednesday and won, correct?
Yeah, clean sweep. All the games in the 6A bracket were 3-0 sweeps except for one of the games. And the Pumas looking to take on Mountain Point tomorrow in a game that is really a tough matchup for them. Talking to Coach Mann, and Mountain Point has some really good players, a really, really good setter, a player that most of our club girls play with during the year.
Ball being juggled out of bounds. Incomplete, falling incomplete. I'm trying to set you up with a segue here. I don't have anything for our next lineup on ad. Third and 5 for Valley Vista.
as Brian, you said, just kind of the seniors trying to play their hearts out, play as hard as they can through the last 8:45 of their careers, their high school careers.
Yeah, the Pumas still leaving defensive starters on the field, so they're going to try to make sure they have everything shored up defensively and maybe show some things they may not normally do and complete there. But this is where you kind of get an opportunity to maybe play some games with your next opponent on film and maybe show some things you may not normally do in situations just to kind of mess up their breakdown of the next week. This is definitely where, when I was coaching, I liked to get, I don't know if the word funky is correct, but do some things they're going to have to put on the chart that you're never going to run again. You just want to make them have to spend another 5 minutes on it.
Make them think a little bit more. Dickey back deep to return. We had a 2-yard punt on the last kick. This one's a lot better. Dickey waves his hand, drops the punt, and he's able to fall on it. If Valley Vista ever needed a little bit of a chance, that was the one, maybe. Maybe. As we take a look here, you see Dickey, a lot of the times just waving his hand, fair catching. That's what he did here, too, on one of the best punts of the night, straight at him. A little bit of a low catch around at his knees, just couldn't hang on. Maybe heard the footsteps of the oncoming Valley Vista defender, muffed it, but was able to fall on it.
Yeah, so the Pumas going to take over at the 40-yard line, and Papa John's is 40% off. That's right.
40%?
Use promo code AZPreps365 during your online order at papajohns.com and receive 40% off your order. Use this for team meals, school meetings, Friday night dinner, etc. Etc. is actually in there. You can use this code as many times as you like from now through May 31st, 2017.
Purdy takes a big hit, as that 40% could take a big hit out of your paycheck, your bill at the end of the meal. I was trying.
Yeah, so Purdy's still in the game.
Took a big shot as well.
Not sure I would have him out there right now.
Number 15, Christian Alvarado, the 5'10", 195 junior, with about 8 minutes left to go in this second. The second half, the final quarter, the final frame. Purdy's going to keep himself. Stay on his feet, spin out of a tackle, do a complete 360 now, having to create Brock Purdy to the 50-yard line, and then steps out of bounds before taking any more damage. It's going to be short of the markers, but a good play from Brock Purdy. Let's take a look here on the replay. Gets the snap in the pistol. Little three-wide set. Met with a free runner, having to spin all the way around, bring everything around town, then with some room to run, and just steps out of bounds at the 50-yard line. Looks like he almost slipped there as well.
Yeah, another big hit almost to put on your quarterback, and so you got to start thinking about self-preservation here for your offensive players.
Now, that was a pass where I'm not very sure who was thrown to. You had Nate and DeShane James, the two brothers, right next to each other. Nate kind of extended out to go catch that one, and I'm not really sure who was intended for.
I think that was supposed to go to DeShane? The little brother, and a little sibling rivalry there. Decided, I'm going to take your toy and not give it back. So good job by the brothers fighting over a ball there.
Sibling rivalry coming through in the middle of the game. Nate James flies in motion, but they're going to look to the sideline and get a different play. And if I'm not mistaken, on the last play now, Coach Jones is going to take a timeout. The running back carousel continues for this Perry team. On the last play, number 28, Jalen Young, the sophomore, was on the field. And offensively, I haven't seen Jalen Young since the Westwood game where he went off.
Yeah, it was one of those players that, talking to some of the coaches, they had high praise for and thought would be a pretty big contributor here. And so we hadn't seen him in a while, and now he's back in there
right,
doing his thing.
.748 left to go. If you ask some of the Perry players, we're not going to name any names here, but if you ask some of the Perry players, the big mindset right now is on Chandler, much to the ire of Brian Rainier and I. Right now, Chandler up big on Basha. Going to be setting up an interesting game. Good 7-10 game going on as well. At least it should be a good game between Desert Vista. Now Deshane James comes in, a quarterback, has a lot of blockers out in front, cups up the field at the hash, stays on his feet, and pushes for the first down onto the VV, the Valley Vista side of the field. First down, Perry, keeping the clock moving, keeping the drive alive. And Deshane's going to slip the gloves right back on as Purdy comes in to play quarterback. Clayson Conrad comes off in favor of Jalen Young, the sophomore, so looks like that's going to be the end of Kenny Fultz's night. Ooh, bobble snap there. He's able to get it to Jalen Young, and Jalen Young doing well to get about 4 or 5 there on the carry. Seven, 10 left to go in the game. 2nd and 6 for the Pumas. Only 2 wide, couple tight ends set. Jalen Young to Purdy's left. 3 wide, excuse me. They're going to give to Young. Young trying to bounce outside and does. Now cuts up the field. Holding flag going to be coming back. As there you can see what's left. And the referee just signaled holding on Perry before the official call. You see the flag right there. 10 yards from the spot, remember, in high school. So this one's going to be coming back. It looks like, let's see if I could do the quick math, to the Perry 49.
Yeah, those penalties are brutal when you get those big holding penalties behind the play. And ends up being pretty significant. Significant. In the grand scheme of things.
2nd and 20 after the holding call. 3 wide. Colby Dickey in there, running back, something new. And they're going to throw to Dickey. Look at that. Colby Dickey catches at the 30 to 25. Trying to cut up the field. Breaks the tackle and gets up to the 15-yard line. Wide open. Big play. Puma first down.
Dickey leaks out of the backfield up the sideline. Again, maybe one of those wrinkles you want to show your next opponent to see if something we can make him prep for during the week.
.6:30 left to go in the game. 1st and 10 from the 13. Pumas can obviously still get a first down here. Don't have to score quite yet. Purdy in the gun. And he's going to give to Young. Jalen Young breaking a tackle. Jalen Young inside the 10 to the 5. Keeping the feet moving. No signal yet. He's in. Touchdown, Perry. Jalen Young, the sophomore, the young buck, gets in from 13 yards out. And there it is. That is the nail in the coffin. Perry go up 55-21.
So, yeah, you see the Purdy checking the sideline for the play here. And Jalen Young moving up into position. Little 2 tackles pulled. Nice little sweep action. Breaks some tackles and drags defenders in the end zone for the touchdown.
Zendejas on for the point after. Good shot right there. Kick is straight through the uprights. 56-21, 6:08 left to go in the ball game. Perry on top big time.
Yeah, this is closer to what we thought when we were looking at this game. Again, Pumas came out a little flat, which is understandable when you have an opponent you don't think is going to be not really matched up too well with you, but you know, Valley Vista was game, trying to hold in there, played tough for that whole first half. But, you know, numbers could also be another thing. You know, Puma's able to roll in more players. Valley Vista, not exactly lacking of people on the sideline, but not exactly with the same amount of players that Perry has with, you know, over 100 players on the roster. So this happens to you sometimes face these bigger schools, and you start to kind of wear down a little bit as the game goes. And Valley Vista has a lot of players that are fighting in there for us. The monsoon all night.
Again, 56-21 our score. 6:08 left to go in the game. Perry, big time on top. Great second half. Made the adjustment on Fadre Gates. As Henson now for the monsoon, taking it sideline to sideline right now. Staying on his feet, almost not kept up after the hit. Good return is going to get him to the 30-ish yard line.
Yeah, nice little return there. You know, this has got some athletes going. He gets some push-ups going. Is that Jake Bills doing push-ups over there?
It looks like Jake Billingsley, but I don't think it is. It better not be, or else he's going to have to answer some questions.
He'd be doing handstand push-ups with an inverted foot hold and then some underneath pull-ups off the fence.
Look at that reverse angle as well. That might be our best cinematography of the entire night, the push-up position.
Hamilton not
for the student
in a,
section.
Not in a lack of game, 47-30 against Tucson. So Hamilton is going to advance to play Perry next week here at Perry High School, but 47-30 Tucson High game to play the Huskies.
That Hamilton game, I mean, 17 points is nothing to sneeze at, but closer than a lot of people would have thought.
Pinnacle, Brophy. Pinnacle goes down to Brophy, 45-35. So most of the Premier Region survives the night, except for Basha, of course. One of them's going to make it out, but everybody else going to go on to the next round. Going to have four schools into the round of eight. So half of them are going to be in, but elimination game for another team next week between Hamilton and Perry. You'd almost think that if you spread them out, there would be, you could almost have a semifinal with three teams and Mountain Points in there at the end if the bracket would have set up correct.
.530 left to go in the game. Vista putting together a decent drive right now on Perry's side of the field. Still with all their starters in. A little bit of a broken play. Vaudrey Gates, breaks a couple pairs of ankles right there on the little juke up the field. Nice move there from Gates. Turns a loss of three or four into a gain of about five or six.
Hey, you see the thing here with Gates is Gates doesn't hesitate in his breaks. And so in high school football, it doesn't matter your size sometimes. When you hit things with speed, as he does, and makes that decision without any hesitation, that's a huge, huge factor in being successful as a ball carrier at this level.
Vaudrey, the 5'8 senior, they're going to go deep here. Could be picked off. That just falls harmlessly to the ground there. Just kind of a jump ball. I mean, you're down by 28 now. No, 35. You're down by 35 now. I mean, why not, really?
Well, here's another good West Valley game. At the end of the season, Verado and Desert Edge played a Thursday night game. Went double overtime. Verado beats them 6-3. Well, they play Desert Ridge and the Edge in the first round of the playoffs. And Desert Edge is up 35-10.
Wow.
So come back the next week in the game that matters. Desert Edge takes care of business.
Vaudrey Gates going down the sideline. Look at him go. Vaudrey Gates getting pushed out inside the 5-yard line. First and goal. The shining star of the night in this monsoon, Vaudrey Gates.
Yeah, he's big night, big numbers all night for Gates. And he's coming back next year. He's going to be a player you're going to have to not want to see in any game because he's definitely a playmaker.
They're going to give to Gates, see if he can find the end zone. Not going to happen. We got three Pumas away in form right there. We said it during the Hamilton game, and I'm going to go ahead and say it right now. It's always a good thing when your coaches are piecing out with over 4 minutes left to go in the game.
Yeah, the coach is comfortably in position to win this game, and so.
That being said, Valley Vista find the end zone late with 4:08 left to go, 56-27 now our score. Nothing much but padding the stats. Looks like they're going to leave their team on to go for two here. Number 23 on the carry and the score, German De Leon for Valley Vista.
Yeah, they're two-point conversion here.
And they're going for two. They look to throw. Got a man open. And he dropped it. Is that Collier number three? Yeah, it is.
Collier's got a little bit of a Michael Floyd in him there.
A little bit, yeah.
He's dropping those balls right in his hands, and he catches the real hard one down here we reviewed earlier. And so, tough night. Other East Valley scores. So a game that Skyline High School was not happy about how the bracket came out. I was talking to Les Wilsley from AIA yesterday out at the state golf tournament that did get rained out, lightninged out. But he was saying how Coach Angelo Pafumi was not happy with the way the bracket broke down and how they had to face Red Mountain, a tough first-round matchup for a team that's seeded as high as Skyline. And who would have thunk it, 13-13 now in that game. So Skyline, Red Mountain, fighting it out over there in the Northeast Valley for that advancing to the playoffs. And Skyline, actually the number four seed, could go down here tonight.
Now, it might be a game you might have to do a little bit of deeper digging for. I'm not sure if you have the score readily available to you right now. The Desert Vista game I was extremely interested in.
Yeah, it wasn't up on the stream I was looking at, so we'll dig that one out.
Valley Vista on the onside kick, get the ball back, making things a little bit interesting. Still down by four scores.
It's when you know your high school game run long when you look at Twitter and they tune in now for the live
recap show.
AIA wrap-up show on 98.7 with Kevin McCabe already on air, and we still have 4 minutes left in this
and
game.
We thought we were running pretty quick as well at the beginning of the half. All for naught. As Valley Vista still playing hard through the final whistle, almost throwing an interception on their first throw. Number 29 for the Pumas on the coverage along with a couple others. Chris Cochran. Four wide, throw on the near sideline, and that's number one on the drop, Gavin Smith. Gavin trying to run without the ball in his hands. There you see Smith right now looking a tad bit dejected.
Desert Vista final.
Here we go.
Tell you how long our games run. 21 minutes ago, Desert Vista wins 28-14 over Mountain View.
Interesting.
Desert Vista 6-4 on the regular season, team that Perry beat early with
in overtime,
their backup
no less.
Quarterback in. So,
Vajri Gates breaks one tackle, gets the first down.
And you know, in that game, they had a player similar to Vajri Gates and Leland Dillard, and Puma's able to stop him all night long. And
that's right. I remember that Leland Dillard and Keyshawn White, the two big guys for Desert Vista. Been hearing a lot of good things out of DV, especially to the guys at Sports 360 AZ. I think that's going to be a little bit of an intriguing matchup next week, DV and Chandler.
Yeah, you got to be worried about a team like Desert Vista with some athletes and some.
Big pass there from Reyes Ole down the way to Gavin Smith. Smith this time pulling this one in. First in goal, Valley Vista.
But with the ability to match scores, that's the thing you always got to worry about.
As you see just a little pump, the bait. This maybe the first time that Perry bit on the bait all night. They had Gates on the flat just kind of as a decoy, throw it deep. Down there to Smith, the senior captain. Big play. Looking over the middle, way behind the receiver, Collier. That falls incomplete. Laura misfiring on that one. Second and goal now from the four. As Valley Vision is trying to make this game look a bit more respectable than the scoreboard would tell you. Second and goal now from the four with 3:19 left to go in the ball game. They send Gates in motion, and they're going to give straight ahead. And it's going to be a touchdown. Valley Vista, number 23 on the carry for the Monsoon. German De Leon on the score, making things a little bit closer. As you see here, they just send Gates in motion straight up the gut. Does well to bounce outside and spin his way into the end zone, keep the feet moving. 56-33 now. And it looks like they're going to keep their offense on the field down by, 23 points. So if they get this, that brings them back to 21.
Yeah, it's one of those things, too. It's
as Laura overthrows his intended receiver.
We got a Puma coach.
I was
going
to say, you love
box.
To see that, right?
Coming back the coaches to stop the bleeding.
Coaches dip with about 4 minutes, and then a couple scores later at 3:14, you want to send the coach right back up.
Trying to see what the backups are doing, see if they're doing what they're supposed to. But, you know, the way this last quarter's gone reminds me of that. One of my favorite segments on the Scott Van Pelt show on ESPN, they call Bad Beats, and they have the games that were bet in college football or any game, and, you know, if it's over, under, or something that comes up, and it looks like the game's over, and all of a sudden a team gets an onside kick, gets a turnover, and you had the under, and all of a sudden game gets an overtime, and the
right.
under's dead in the water. It's pretty funny because, you know, there's a lot of guys counting their money, but in this game, if you had the over, I don't know what the over would have been, probably 60 plus. That's only for stats purposes. No actual gambling occurring. Our stats class here at Perry High School actually does a whole section on poker and the statistics for poker and what certain hands and your chances and odds when you certain things are up on the board. So good way to teach probability. Aren't you in that class?
I am in that class, yes.
You
we
the not poker part yet?
Not gotten that
21
that far
well.
Quite yet.
Yeah, you got to be a little bit Rain Man-ish to be able to count that quick. Another reference that probably nobody that was born after 1990. Well, 1980 probably gets.
Zach Johnson checking into the game for the Pumas. The fourth running back. That is right. We've hit the cycle at running back at the running back position. Johnson getting a carry, the fourth. Different person we've seen, or even more than fourth, but the fourth player listed as a running back getting a carry. Talk about Fultz, Conrad, Jalen Young, and now Johnson as well.
Talking, hit the cycle, you're going to use a baseball reference. We'll see what the Valley's like coming spring training when the Cubs get back in town.
They're oh, very true.
Illinois transplants in there, and they all come out here because the weather's so nice, and Cubs winning that World Series game. That we talked about today is that I was watching that game and saw the rain delay, and I put my head down and woke up, game was over.
There it is.
I missed the entire extra inning after investing that time into the game. I actually got a text from my wife who was in San Francisco for work, and she said, can you talk? I said, no, the game was in the seventh inning. I'm not talking right now. and I missed the extra inning, so. Not the way I envisioned that, but that rain delay was supposed to take 40 minutes, and it took 10.
What a great game that was, especially for – it's kind of the funny thing about baseball in that Aroldis Chapman comes in the eighth inning, right, gives up the big home run to Rajai Davis, is in position to possibly get a loss, depending on what happens, blows a save, and then comes right around and gets the win.
Yeah,
funny how baseball works like that.
You can imagine if they would have lost that game, how much Joe Madden would have been dealing with the press and everybody in town talking about the mistakes.
Even still looking back at that game, even though they got the win, it's just some of those moves he made are just kind of head-scratchers.
Yeah.
He had Kyle Hendricks in there pitching a gem, only giving up one run. You pull him out for Lester. What happens? Lester on a wild pitch, two runs on one pitch. And then after that, Lester finds – kind of settles in, gives up a walk or something like that. Then they pull him for Chapman. And, of course, what happens? Chapman gives up the two-run bomb.
Yeah, the Indians really able to put some good at-bats in there against Chapman in that inning. And fouling balls off that they didn't want and staying in the count. And, you know, that was a great job by Rajai Davis hitting that home run. And I thought the Indians had that thing won at that point. But old Mo got killed by a little bit of a rainstorm, and so that was probably the Major League Baseball's put the tarps out, slow it down.
Yeah.
Oh, no, it's not going to rain. Let's go back out there. Because it really wasn't raining that hard, it looked like, on the team. So all your conspiracy theorists, that's actually a class here at Perry, or a club here at Perry.
A conspiracy theory club.
And so maybe that's one they'll have to go over. And did Major League Baseball.
Major League Baseball.
Roll out the tarps when they didn't need to be out. We have some obscure clubs here at Perry High School, so that being one of them. Also the ukulele club.
Yep.
Pokemon club. Harry Potter club. We got a lot of them. But none being as more obscure than the Multimedia and Film Club that you are the president of.
The presidents, yes.
All of our meetings.
I'm pretty sure what was a unanimous vote.
Yes. Most definitely unanimous vote. I don't think that's going to happen. Bartman's been very adamant about staying out of the spotlight no matter what. And so, you know, Cubs fans like to have a whipping boy, and I don't know who they're going to have anymore. And there's actually a local restaurant here in town that is owned by Chicago natives and actually roasted a goat before the start of the first game. Yeah. And so all those gimmicks, those huge Midwesterner fans kind of love. We get a lot of carryover in the Valley with those Illinois transplants. I played on a softball team that was all Illinois transplants, so, and they were rooting hard. One of my buddies is actually in PR in Las Vegas, had a big event the day of the Game 7 game, and he had a Cubs jersey on underneath his suit.
Oh, really?
Yes. And he busted. It's a picture online where he's got his suit shirt opened up and you see the Cubs jersey on underneath.
The Arizona Cardinals are now the new Chicago Cubs, hold the longest streak now without winning a championship since 1948.
And the last time they won it was when they were in Chicago. So all comes back around. And believe it or not, the favorite for the Super Bowl title this year were those Cardinals, and probably not likely to happen this year. Yeah, a lot of scenarios there. They're not a team that's performed to what the expectation was definitely throughout this year. And so, you know, the Cardinals, the one thing we kind of do deal with in this town, when there are expectations, usually doesn't go well. Six and seven.
There you go.
Yeah. End up 6-7 with a very bad season. Lost to Texas A&M early and never got their footing from that point on. Only one big win over UCLA was it for them. And a little quick kick here by Purdy, a la ASU.
Oh, hit a cameraman, Jay Reese.
Nice.
Out of bounds.
Cheerleaders cheering on Jay Reitz.
Jay Reitz, yeah, they might. Yeah, you know, he got hit pretty hard there.
We'll see if Valley Vista does. They just take a knee or they run the trick play of all trick plays.
the 23-pointer.
The 23-point play. That does exist in some coaches' minds. Valley Vista Monsoon, I'm pretty sure that's probably, I don't think there's any other team in the nation that probably has that mascot, so the Pumas, probably a fairly common mascot. I thought we should have been the Perry Pachyderms or something cool like that, but.
The Perry Pachyderms.
Or the Vacas, since this is this campus used to be a big hit there at the end of the play, but campus used to be a dairy farm, so.
Right.
Probably plenty of dead cows buried along this land that we're sitting on.
So with 4 point, explain something to me right now, Brian. 4.7 seconds left to go. You get a first down. You're down by 23, and you call timeout.
Stats, baby, stats.
All about the stats.
Open enrollment here in Arizona. Never know, a kid may be pulling up stats and going, hey, you know what? Look at that. They have all this offense in this year, and that's where I want to go to school. So pad the stats. Valley Vista, first year in the Big Boy Conference, makes it to the playoffs and
put up a good first half fight. Just got overmatched. I think the depth killed them. As you mentioned, Perry have double the players that Valley Vista have on the Max Preps roster. Perry's listed at over 100, and Valley Vista just over 50. I think something like at 53.
Yeah, so that definitely affects it. And so it's something we got to look at. Let's see what they come up with here. Maybe a little double flea flicker reverse. Nope, just a little.
Or just a little pass out on the flat. I'll tell you what, talk about patting the stats. Vaudre Gage just added 20 yards at the end of that reception. But you hear the horns, you hear everything going off. That is the end of our game. We made it one of the most interesting broadcasts I've ever been a part of, from start, or late start that is, to finish. Our final here at John Wren Stadium, 56-33. Perry come on top against Valley Vista, as we all expected them to be, and they're going to be taking on Hamilton. That game, next Thursday night, Thursday, November 10th, Veterans Day Eve, going to be broadcasted right here on PS4, on Sports 360 AZ. The crew will be here to bring you round two of the AIA State Playoffs. Again, our final score, Perry 56, Valley Vista 33. The Pumas survived the monsoon and move on to face the Huskies in a rematch of earlier this season that we brought to you at Hamilton High School. Perry get the 23-point win. For Brian Brenier, everybody else here, the PS4 crew, I'm Jordan Palacio wishing you all a good night, and we'll see you next Thursday night for Perry versus Hamilton. Good night, everybody.